Salutations, everybody. Welcome back to another vertical video tutorial. How you doing? Are you here to learn how to do that? Well, you're going to. Yeah, let's just do this. Intro. Salutations, everybody. Benjamin Brandon here, back with another vertical video tutorial. I already said that, right? If you're new to this channel, I'm all about vertical video. I'm a vertical filmmaker, IGTV influencer. I'm just all about the VERRT. Oh yeah, and I'm the creator of hashtag VERRT, which is an awesome vertical video community on Facebook where I hang out with all my friends. Link below. Now, with further ado, let's get into today's tutorial. So last week on Instagram, I shared a flood of stories asking you what you wanted to learn from me from a video production standpoint, a VERRT standpoint, IGTV, whatever. And oh my goodness, I'm still going through them, by the way. I'm still going through them. That's amazing. Thank you for wanting to learn. So as you know, if you are not new here, you be asking and I be telling. Today I'm fulfilling one of the most requested tutorials from that flood of story replies, and that is how to make yourself disappear. On my vertical films and in my vertical vlogs, I do this constant effect of me disappearing. Well, obviously you saw that from the intro, but it's kind of been one of my go-to effects for my vertical films. And so now that you've asked for it, let's show you how to do it. Step one, you gotta make sure that you have a good background to make this effect easier in Final Cut Pro.
Kind of like this.
P.S. You can do this in Premiere and whatever else you're using too. It's pretty basic. What do I mean by the right background? It's just easiest if your background doesn't move or you don't have any moving objects. So for this intro, that was really easy because there's nothing moving behind me. And yeah, you've probably seen me do this effect outside, which A, yes, you can do, but it takes double the time. So make sure you choose the right background. Step two. When you do get that background, make sure you have a lockdown shot using a tripod. And also for the best effect, try to frame a medium shot, as you see right here. This is also a medium shot, by the way. It's flirting with the long medium shot, actually. Benefits of a 15 mil, I guess. Okay, for step three, what you're gonna wanna do is take footage of that background by itself, not with you in it, so get out, Ben, thanks. Take about 5 to 10 seconds of footage and be careful. Make sure if you're using autofocus that you're actually focused on the wall that you're gonna appear on. As you can see here, it kind of blurs a little bit, and that's just the autofocus not understanding where to focus. Makes sense. So keep that in mind. Once your 5 to 10 seconds of background footage is complete, then insert yourself into the frame. Wiggle around a little bit just to make sure that your camera focuses on you. Oh, another thing, it's also super imperative that you make sure you don't move anything. Like, even a slight little like this ruins the entire effect. Now that you have yourself inserted into frame, make sure you don't move a lot. Make sure you don't move, Ben. Thank you. And try to keep as still as possible. Now, the way I do this effect is I introduce myself into a different location and then I start dialogue right away. So if you're gonna do the same, make sure you just stand still for about 5 seconds and then go ahead and start your dialogue. Or you can use it for a really cool effect when you know transport to get coffee. Moving on to phase two. So now let's import into Final Cut Pro. We will grab our footage and then create a new project. And you've learned this from the last tutorial. Custom, you just switch, right? 1080 to 1920. Frame rate, not something I got into last time, but I have gotten into in a lot of other videos. Match the frame rate that you shot on your camera. Simple as that. I don't have true native 24p, so I have 23.98 frame rate, so that's what I'll choose. And then hit okay. The first thing you're gonna do is rotate your file. So to rotate it, you'll just simply go to your inspector and go to rotate and select 90 or negative 90, depending on where you shot. Boom, there we go. And then you pop it up a little bit. Once it snaps, you're theoretically okay. However, for IGTV, I've found that sometimes it actually creates like a weird like green line. So I actually zoom in just a little more. So instead of it snapping and stopping, I go just a little outside the lines like that. It's still fine, framing's good, no quality loss there. Now the first thing I'm gonna look for is the footage of just the background without me in the frame. This is actually not too in focus, which is okay because that means it's focusing on the wall. So I'm gonna select the longest segment that doesn't have any movement or shadows. So I think about here. Now I'm gonna find the segment in which I'm in frame. And then I have some dialogue, right? So I'll do this, stop. Command B to cut that part. And then boom, about right there. It's about 2 seconds before I dialogue. That's actually too long, so I'll make it just a little less. There we go. So already what you can see is the effect kind of happening a little bit. And I'm there, then boop. That little pop zoom thing that you see, the little that's my camera changing focus perspectives. So it understands that I'm there now. So it doesn't look that good yet, right? It doesn't look as seamless as you need it to be. So here's what you do to fix that. And the great thing about what I'm gonna show you here is you don't need any plugins. So what you're gonna do is go into your transitions, go to your dissolve, and select cross dissolve. Just pop it right in between those clips. And already you can see that that was kind of cool. If I were to play this back in real time, the way I would want it in my IGTV video or VERRT blog or Instagram story, whatever, is I would just leave it like that. And boom, there you go.
Kind of like this.
Now I want to spice it up just a little more. So now clicking on the cross dissolve, that looks okay. Just make sure you do one or two things. One, make sure you go to ease and then in, because that you're moving into something or transitioning into another frame, which is you, and there you go. And depending how smooth your shot is, whether it's super smooth or not that smooth, you can select ease amount and boost that up some, and it just becomes just a little better and a little quicker too. There you go. And then the last thing I'll probably do to spice it up is just put a, you know, cool sound effect. So I'll do this little whooshy thing. Pair it up enough to where it makes sense. That looks a little high, so I'll drop that down and let's see how that looks. Super simple, right? Boom, you're done. Now lastly, another cool thing you can do is if you have a luma transition of some sort, you can pop in a luma transition and that gives you an even cooler effect like this. And then you can see here that it's warpy, but it's covering the frame. It's just not, that doesn't look too good, right? So here's how you fix that. What you just learned previously with the cross dissolve is the easy way. This is the more technical, advanced way, especially when you're using a luma transition. What I'll do for now is I'll just cut away the transition, and then depending on where I'm standing before my line, I will hit M for marker. This lets me know when I'm talking and when the transition should end. And what I'll actually do here is hit B to cut that part and isolate this portion of the clip. Now, the reason why I'm doing that is because I'm going to go ahead and use something called a draw mask. Go to effects, you then go to masks, and the draw mask is the first one there. Pop that on. Now, you'll see as you hover to your viewer, you'll get this little pen thing. What this pen thing does is it allows you to select a portion of the frame. In this case, it will be me that wants to appear. So, and then I'll just go ahead and start selecting myself. I'll also just kind of zoom in a little bit just to make sure that I get everything I need. There we go. Welcome back, that took a while. But now that you've done that, what you do is you can see here in the frame that, okay, it's just a weird, just me there. Now real quick, you wanna be selected here, and the way you do that where you just kinda isolate yourself out is make sure that the invert mask is not selected, as you can see here. So because you cut yourself out, you'll then be able to drag that clip with the draw mask right up to the background footage, and then pop in a luma transition, which makes this just that much tastier. And let's pop the sound effect on, and here we go. Ooh. Oh, that's dope. And to get that appearing and disappearing effect, you wanna make sure that you have your transition, your luma transition, at the beginning of the draw mask clip and at the end of the draw mask clip. The great thing is, as you saw, I'll do it again, just dragging it into your clip does that for you. And in and out. That's it. And now you know how to make yourself appear and disappear. Awesome. Anyway, guys, that is it for today's vertical video tutorial. If you found this valuable, do me a favor and smash that like button for me. Wait a minute, here it comes. Here's my phone. And get after it. Subscribe for more videos just like this to enhance your vertical video quality, along with getting some IGTV tips and vertical vlogs on this channel and all that fun stuff. And if you are looking to dominate IGTV, such as the people watching this channel and myself, I would totally look at the IGTV Masterclass linked in the description below. It is an awesome online course that teaches you everything that I've learned and have done to gain some success on IGTV, and it's super cheap and affordable, so there you go. And I, my beautiful VERRT friends, will see you on the next video. I was gonna walk out, but I'll just, bye.